Why is it that that second putt is always so easy? If I just had one mulligan every hole, I'd be one of the best players in the world. Well, today we're going to talk about a topic I simply call Mulligan Please. Hi, I'm Jeff Mitchell with the Golf Standard, and Mulligan Please is about what I consider to be my superpower, and that's my power of observation. For every shot, the more I can get information, the better I'm going to perform. If I had a mulligan on every shot, I can promise you I'm going to play a lot better golf. Well, you can't do that on the golf course. So what you have to do is have great powers of observation. Here, my opponent has a golf ball slightly outside of mine, as you can see marked with a quarter. Well, I'm going to try to use their golf ball to help me read the green. So when my opponent sets up to the ball here, I'm going to try to make sure that I'm in a position where I can walk right in, see this line of putt, especially at the end when the speed is dropping, and it's going to help give me the confidence I need to make better putts. So what I would do is, as he is set up there, I would get at about a 45 degree angle, get far enough away where I'm not interfering, but close enough so that as soon as he hits that putt, I can step right in, I can watch the end of that putt. So not only am I going to watch everybody's putt, I'm going to really try to watch that if it's close to my line, but I'm actually going to watch basically every shot that's hit, because every one of those is going to give me a little bit of information that might make my decisions better. On this chip, even if I don't have a chip from the same spot, I might watch this just to see how that ball reacts when it lands on the green. That took a very thumpy kind of a bounce, and that's going to tell me a lot about the decisions I want to make as I'm hitting chips around the green. So in this circumstance, we have a par three. It's about 165 yards, a little downhill, just a little bit of right to left wind. And I can use this same scenario if I'm in the fairway watching someone hit an approach shot. If I'm not the first one to play, I want to try to make sure I know what kind of shot they're trying to hit, what club they're using, and see how it reacts with the wind, see if that downhill makes the difference that I think it should. But in any case, I want to make sure that I'm watching for anything that might be different than what I think should happen. So in this scenario, I've got what looks to be a drivable par four. We've got a fairway going out this way. But if you look just to the right of the trees in there, that's where the green actually is. You can just see the flag sticking up out there. And I'm trying to figure out really whether I want to try and play the safe way out or here really take advantage of the fact that I can reach this green. Now, if I'm not first to hit, I'm going to make sure that I watch very closely what the other players are doing, and I want to try and get any kind of information I can out of that. But probably more than anything, I want to pay attention to what I'm doing. I want to make sure that I'm making decisions that are based on things that I feel confident about, that I am positive that I can get a good result with. So that's going to be a very important part of this, is not only do I want to be observative of the other players, I watch every shot, I pay attention to the circumstances with the wind, or right now it's starting to get real humid, we got a little bit of rain in the area. I want to watch for those. I watch every other player hit and see what kind of an impact those different changing conditions have. But lastly, I want to make sure that what I'm doing mostly is observing what I'm doing myself. Am I making good decisions? Am I learning from all these different circumstances? If I really want to be a good player, I want to be able to play without needing a mulligan, because I'm using all these different types of resources when I make my decisions. It's going to give me confidence and I'm going to play better golf. I hope you enjoy Mulligan Please. Until next time.